हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू एड्यू टैप एंड ऑल्सो वेलकम टू द यू नो टूडेज लेक्चर विच इज़ ऑन एनिमल हस्बेंड्री एंड पोल्ट्री. सो आई थिंक वन इज देयर. सो इज़ माई वॉइस ऑडिबल एंड इफ द स्क्रीन इज विजिबल देन आई कैन स्टार्ट विद द सेशन. Is it visible? My So guys, if my voice is audible, can you please give me a thumbs up sign so that I can understand and start with the session. Visible, okay, fine. Thanks Sachin. So today's session is on animal husbandry and poultry. So before starting with the session, a small announcement regarding our 2021 courses for RBI grade B, SEBI grade A and NABARD grade A. And for further details or queries, you can, you know, reach to us through any of these sites, that is edutab.co.in or the phone number, or you can write to us. And also one more important announcement, you know, we were getting so many queries regarding the, you know, AFO. Either for courses or you know for series. So we are going to launch courses for AFO very soon, and also we'll be starting series for AFO very soon. So with this, let's start with the session. The first question, it says curled toe paralysis. It's a disease in chicks. It's a symptom that is caused due to deficiency of which of the following elements? Curled toe paralysis. Anyone? No answers? Okay. Here the correct answer is riboflavin. Because of this, you know, curled toe paralysis, it occurs. It's a symptom. As you can see here in this photograph, the toes are curled, and you know, this affected chicks soon become, you know, they because of this curled toes, they'll not be curled toes, they'll not be able to move properly. Riboflavin is nothing but vitamin B2, and this generally happens in young chicks because of this deficiency. Next, grass tetany. It's an in animals is caused due to deficiency of which of the following elements? Grass tetany is a disease where it's, you know, it affects the muscles and their movement. The animal movement is restricted, and this generally occurs, you know, when during the springtime, the, you know, the first leaves that come out. So when the animals, they feed on that type of grasses, then this deficiency happens. And correct answer is magnesium. Because of this deficiency, grass tetany occurs in animals. And as I have mentioned, when they typically graze on the, you know, fresh leaves that come immediately after, you know, during spring, after snowing and everything, then it happens. And and this mostly occurs and most commonly found in, or these pregnant lactating animals are most susceptible to this disease because of the loss of magnesium in their milk. And they get the symptoms are the excitement and muscular spasms. As I have mentioned, the movement is, you know, affected. So this is the one. Next question is, see, I'm not getting any answers from you. Is it visible or not? Or okay, next question is, dash is a nutrient rich fluid produced by female mammals immediately after giving birth, which is loaded with immune growth and tissue repair factors. What is that, you know, first milk called? Anyone? I thought this is one of the easiest questions, and this was once asked in, you know, I think 2019 or 2020. No, this means 2020 NABARD means this question was asked, and these questions are useful for both NABARD and AFO as well. Anyone? Okay, Ram Ratan Sahu is saying 4, Sachin is saying 1. Okay, Sachin is right here. It's colostrum. And can anyone tell me this? See, this colostrum is, you know, little bit yellowish orange in color. Can someone tell me why it is that? What is a pigment, or because of which, you know, this colostrum is yellow or orange in color? Anyone? See, this is because of the beta carotenes that are present in that. Because of that, the colostrum is dark yellow or orange in color, and this colostrum need to be fed to the calf, newly born calf, at least for the first 10 days and first 3 days exclusively. After that, you know, with some feed. And see, these are the immune factors that are present in bovine colostrum, milligrams per ml. Yes, Sachin, more carotene than normal beta carotene. And here, as you can see, these are the immunoglobulins that are present, A, G, G2 and M. And immunoglobulin G is highest, that is present in colostrum. And this is how it looks, colostrum milk, dark color. Next question. The peculiarity of Neeli Ravi, it's a breed of buffalo, is in respect to physical characteristics is it completely off-white color, straight horns, walking gait, wall eyes? Which is that peculiar, you know, physical characteristic of Neeli Ravi, one breed of buffalo, that once you see that, you can immediately recognize that, okay, this is Neeli Ravi buffalo. What is that physical trait? Anyone? Sachin, Ram Ratan, Sachin 4. Okay. Okay. Yes, Sachin. Correct answer is wall eyes only. What are wall eyes? See here, as you can see, opaque white, you know, layer would be present. That's called wall eye. And Neeli Ravi, it's also called Panch Kalyani. And this is, you know, home, native of Satluj and Ravi rivers, and near belt between those rivers in undivided Punjab. And mane is white markings on its face, forehead, face, muzzle and legs, and walled eyes. And because of this peculiar white markings, it's also called Panch Kalyani. And these are also very good milkers, and, you know, comparable to Murra. Average milk production of this buffalo is 1850 kilograms with 6.8% fat, and lactation yield ranges from 1500 plus to 1900 plus kgs. So this is about Neeli Ravi, which has walled eyes, which is one peculiar character. Next, what is the percentage of fat in single toned milk? Anyone? What is the percentage of fat? Anyone? Swapnil, Sachin, Ramratan. Sachin is saying it's 3%. Okay. Yes, correct answer is 3%. And if it is double toned, then it would be 1.5%. Yes, Swapnil, it's 3%. See, single toned milk is how they do. They add skimmed milk powder and water to whole milk and make single toned milk. And the single toned milk is this one. Energy is 59, 3.1% fat, carbohydrates 4.7%, protein percentage is 3.1% and calcium is 127. I think it's 127 milligram per 100 ml. This I will check. So here, as you can see, it has 3% fat and double toned milk. It is a similar product, but the fat content is reduced to 1.5%. Next, what is the major milk protein present in milk? What is a major milk protein that is present in the milk? Anyone? Swapnil, Sachin. Okay, Ramratan, he is saying 4, lactose. Okay. Sachin is saying, okay, 2, casein. Swapnil too. Okay, most of you are right. Yes, the correct answer is casein. Casein is the, you know, major milk protein that is present in there. Two kinds of protein you can find in milk. One is casein, the other is whey protein. Casein constitutes at least 80% of the total protein content that is present in milk, and whey protein 20%. It is especially in bovine milk. And casein is white in color, which imparts white color to the milk. So this is about milk and milk protein. Next is, synthesis of milk takes place in which part? Yes, Swapnil, it's milk sugar. That's why, you know, few people can't digest that. We call them lactose intolerant. Anyone? Sachin is saying 4 alveolus. Okay. Anyone else? Swapnil, Ramratan, and who else? Okay. Only 3 are active here currently. Okay. Yes, Sachin, you are right. Synthesis of milk takes place in alveolus, which is a part in the udder of bovines. C. This is an udder quarter, and here, as you can see, these are the alveoli, and from this milk is prepared and they move into this milk cistern, and slowly they move into the teat cistern. This is a teat, and from here teat canal the milk can be extracted, and this is the structure, upper structure of the alveolus, how it resembles. And we are not going to get into, I mean, into deep into this segment, but we need to understand that in which part that milk is produced, that is alveoli, and it is, you know, it is within the mammary gland, and it is the one that is a milk producing unit, that is alveolus. and is a single layer of that epithelial cell, secretory cells, and this is not that required, which is connected to a duct system. And from here, this is a structure here. Epithelial, tissue, secretory cells, and then from here they'll have connected system to duct system, and here milk is produced, and this will slowly pass on to the milk cistern. This is what we are concerned with. So this is how milk is produced in animals in alveoli. Next, Dhoni breed of cattle is found in which of the following states in India? Dhoni breed of, anyone? Dhoni breed. No one? Ram Ratan Sahu is saying one. Sachin is saying two. Maharashtra Swapnil is also saying two. Yes, most of you are right. It is Maharashtra. And where, in which district? There is a place called Dhoni. From there, this breed got the name. Okay, no one. So here, see, it's a taluka in Latur district. So it is named after that Dhoni, which is in Maharashtra, and this is also distributed in Latur, Nanded, Osmanabad, Parbhani districts of Maharashtra. And here this Dhoni, it is used for drought purposes, mostly for drought purposes, because of its sturdy structure and the type of pressure it can take, work pressure. Next, adulteration of milk by starch can be detected by which of the following test? Yes, in Bidar you can find even this in few tracts of Karnataka as well. Bidar is in Karnataka only. Next, adulteration of milk by starch can be detected by which of the following test? Okay, I'm not able to see any questions. Okay, Abhishek is saying one. Sachin is saying one. Yes, the correct answer is one. It's iodine test. And see, once you mix iodine with this, because of the starch that is present, carbohydrates, immediately that will turn to for the adulteration of milk with starch. Next question. Which of the following breeds of sheep in India, it's known as, especially in Rajasthan, it's called as Merino of Rajasthan? Which of the following breeds of sheep is called as Merino of Rajasthan because of the that characteristics of that wool that it produces? Okay, Abhishek is saying 2, Sachin 2, Ram Ratan 2. Yes, the correct answer is Chokla. And it, a native of Churu, Shikhar and Nagaur districts. And the wool produced by Chokla is heterogeneous and generally mixed with coarser fleece of other sheep before utilization as carpet wool. This is also called as Ratamunda because of the dark brown colored face. Not dark face, it's called Ratamunda. That you can see here, polled here means both sexes are wool producer among all the Rajasthan breed sheep breeds. And yes, average yield is between 1.5 to 1.7 kg per annum. So this is about Chokla, Merino of Rajasthan, we can say, and it grows the finest carpet wool among all Indian breeds, especially not only Rajasthan. So with this we have done 10 questions for today's session. Next we shall see some information or some facts about that is useful for exam as well. So what is this? What is a breed of poultry is it? What breed of poultry. What is this breed? Yes, Sachin, it is Kadaknath. Can you tell me why is the color of Kadaknath? This is black in color. You know, even the internal organs, you know, the flesh, bones, that also they are black in color. Yes, black meat. Eggs are not black. Eggs are normal, just like any other, breed. Brown eggs, brownish to light creamish in color, eggs are. Yes, it's also called Kalamasi. It is native of Madhya Pradesh. Can you tell me what pigment that imparts that color, that dark color to it, to Kadaknath? See, this is a scientific name of it is Gallus, Gallus domesticus, family is Phasianidae. Yes, Abhishek, it's melanin pigment because of which it is dark in color and it has high protein and low fat content, which is considered to be highly nutritional, and it is one of the costliest chicken. Why? Because generally broilers, they grow up to 2.5 kg in just 45 days, but this one takes more than 6 months to attain 1.5 kg weight, and also the fertility rate is very low. Because of that, the cost of rearing them is very high. And yes, the color is because of melanin. Not only the flesh, even bones to some part, they are all dark in color. And it is considered to be originated from Kativar, Alirajapur jungles in Jabua district of Madhya Pradesh. This was in recently news, there was even a scam in Maharashtra also. So this is all for today's session. Any queries, any questions? Any queries, questions from anyone, or shall I call it a day? Hope this session was useful to you. And I can't see any questions. Last week I couldn't take class because of network issues at my end. Before that, someone was asking about some test series. See, you can visit any site wherever you can get MCQ, this mock test. So if you can attend as many mock tests as possible, it would be easy for you to attempt the main exam. So it's not that this particular mock test series is good or that series is good. All are almost on the same lines. A4 main test are him, ma'am. Ramratan, pardon, Ramratan, can you please come back with your question again? I couldn't get, mujhe samajh mein nahi aaya ye. ये सारे क्वेश्चंस यस A4 के लिए भी इम्पोर्टेंट है. एंड ऑल्सो वी आर ऑल्सो कमिंग अप विथ A4 सीरीज एज वेल एंड देन A4 कोर्सेस एज वेल, स्पेशली फॉर मेंस. ओके, so I think you don't have any other questions. Thank you, Sachin. Thank you everyone for your patience listening, and if you have any queries, you can always write to us. Thank you very much.